Hello everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. Welcome to the GS paper 4 class. Today we are going to understand the most important topics from the topic from the perspective of GS paper 4, and that is understanding ethical ideas in Buddhism. So there are two very prominent religions when it comes to GS paper 4, that is Buddhism and Jainism. And there are many important learnings in these two religions, these two open-ended religions, which can help us further in administration and governance. So what are these ideas? What are these ideals which we can use in our day-to-day administration, in our day-to-day governance? Which ideas can the administrator use or the government can use to better administer the citizens or the district? We are going to study that. The class notes will be available on my Telegram channel. You simplifying UPSC with ease. Let's start with the class. Also, I'm going to take three important classes, free classes on Unacademy Plus on 5th July 2020. The links to all those three classes are given in the description box below the video. Now, when we talk about Buddhism, jab hum Buddhism ki baat karte hain, we are going to understand Buddhism, the concept. We are going to understand the use of the ideas of Buddhism in our governance with real life examples. When we talk about the idea of Buddhism, jab hum Buddhism as an idea baat karte hain, right? Here, when we talk about Buddhism, we should know few things. Kuch cheeze hume pata honi chahiye. You can take out your pen, paper, notes, jahan par bhi aap GS paper 4 ke notes banate hain, and you can note these points down. Buddhism is a religion which embraces almost everyone. That means that there are no restrictions to join this religion, okay? Or to be a part of this religion. There are no restrictions, almost no restrictions. Secondly, this religion talks about liberation as an achievable thing. That means it is very much achievable. In Hindu scriptures, in many other scriptures, achieving liberation is a very hard task, but in Buddhism, liberation comes very easily. How? If you can focus, if you can be mindful, if you can be compassionate, if you are truthful or honest, if you have strong concentration, right? Then liberation is yours, right? Us case mein liberation and enlightenment aapki hai. These are the prerequisites which are very important, necessary in Buddhism, right? So Buddhism talks about becoming compassionate. Buddhism talks about the qualities which a leader requires, which can enhance your followingship, right? Which can enhance your or increase your followers. So Buddhism basically is a very beautiful religion, and there are many points in Buddhism which can be used by an administrator in his or her district to administer the citizens well. So what are those points? We are going to look into that. So Buddhism is a spiritual religious faith founded in India around 500 BC by Gautam Buddha. And there are certain ethics which are found in Buddhism, which you can apply in governance. Now the next question comes, what is ethics? What exactly are ethics? Then only we can understand what are Buddhist ethics, right? Ethics ki definition pata hogi, tabhi hum samajh payenge ki Buddhist ethics kya hote hain. So when we look at ethics, jab hum ethics ki taraf dekhte hain, it is study of what is right or wrong in human conduct. The way you are conducting your life, your society, what is right or what is wrong is ethics. It is also known as the moral philosophy. But there is a huge difference between ethics and morals. Now, ethics are reasoning, which are in reasoning involved. In ethics, we have reasoning. And in morals, it adhere to what is described. In ethics, it is beyond rules and regulations. It is what is actually right and what is actually wrong, beyond any rules or regulations. But in morals, there are rules and regulations to which you have to stick to. Then ethics, it is usually considered universal. It is present in or you know, you can say almost every sector, almost every area of your life. But morals are relative to society or culture. Ethics are required for survival of the society, but morals are required for the survival of individual. This is the basic difference between ethics and morals. This is very important for section A in GS paper 4. So basically, if we put it in simple words, agar hum simple words mein likhe, write it down. Ethics equals to morals plus reasoning. Alright, this is the basic definition of ethics. So a simple example you may take, you might feel that it is morally wrong to steal. But if you have an ethical viewpoint on it, it should be based on some sets of arguments and analysis about why it would be wrong to steal. So the moral is all about adhering to what is described by society or by religion. But to be ethical means you should figure out what is right by applying some principles and considering all the complexities which are involved. So clearly, the ethical life is the harder path. Now we shall study the different determinants of ethics. What are determinants? When we look at determinants, these are the sources. Write it down. These are sources from which ethical standards arises. तो कहाँ से हमें पता चलता है कि ये चीज ethical है, ये चीज unethical है? How can we deduce that this is ethical and this is unethical? Through these determinants. First determinant is religion. पहला determinant होता है religion. Second determinant is law. Third determinant is society. Fourth determinant is individual. Fifth determinant is knowledge. And sixth determinant is time. So these are the different determinants through which we can determine what is ethical and what is unethical. For example, if you are a priest in a temple, maan lo aap ek priest ho temple ke. For you to decide what is ethical and unethical, you will rely on the religion, right? Aap religion, scripture pe depend karoge. If you are a judge, for you to decide what is ethical and unethical, you will rely on law. आप लॉ पे रिलाई करोगे यार अगर आप जज हो या पुलिस ऑफिसर हो या एक आईएएस ऑफिसर हो. एथिकल क्या है, अनएथिकल क्या है, आप लॉ पे डिपेंड करोगे. राइट, क्लियर? सो इफ यू आर अ टीचर, अगर आप एक टीचर हो, व्हाट इज अनएथिकल एंड एथिकल, यू विल डिपेंड ऑन नॉलेज. राइट, सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट डिटर्मिनेंट्स टू डिटरमाइन व्हाट इज एक्चुअली एथिकल एंड व्हाट इज एक्चुअली अनएथिकल. नाउ देयर आर डिफरेंट डायमेंशंस ऑफ एथिक्स. अब एथिक्स के अलग अलग डायमेंशंस हैं, अलग अलग फेजेस हैं. First dimension is known as meta-ethics. This is the first dimension. Second dimension is known as prescriptive ethics. That is normative ethics. Third dimension is known as descriptive ethics. That means comparative ethics. Please write it down. This is very important for GS paper 4. And fourth dimension is applied ethics. That means when you apply the principles of ethics. Right? Clear everyone? Itna samajh aa gaya sabko? So ethics is not just a theoretical science. Ethics sirf ek theoretical science nahi hai. It has a lot of applications in day-to-day life. So meta-ethics is, you can write it down, ethics about ethics. That is meta-ethics. Prescriptive ethics is normative ethics. Descriptive is comparative. These are the different dimensions of ethics. So now back to our today's topic, that is Buddhism. We have understood what is ethics. Hame itna pata chal gaya ethics kya hai, right? What is right, what is wrong? That decision is ethics. So Buddhist ethics used to describe the systems of morality as well as styles of moral reasoning that have emerged in Buddhist traditions. Here you can see how can you talk about moral reasoning. Moral reasoning क्या है, आपको कैसे पता चलेगा? It is based on your actions. You can relate it with your actions. Action means karma, right? And always remember that actions are of two types. In Buddhism, actions are of two types. Akushila, that is the bad actions, and kushila, that is the good actions. Akushila means greed, hatred, selfishness, lust, anger, lying about something, that is akushila, that is bad deeds. Kushila means generosity, love, wisdom, that is the good deeds, right? Usko hum bolte hain kushila in Pali language. And actions, always remember, they are not done abruptly. Actions are prompted by intentions. If you have no intentions, then no actions can take place. For example, you are preparing for an exam. You are studying. That is an action. But why did this action occur? Because you had an intention to become a civil servant, right? So without an intention, you cannot perform your actions. If somebody is killing somebody else, ek person hai, person A is killing person B. Without any intention, he will not do this murder. Only if he has an intention, he will commit this crime, right? So without intention, you cannot undertake an action. Always remember. Now, there are moral guidance which are given in Buddhism through Eightfold Path, which is also known as Dharma Chakra Parvartana. Okay? Now, there are Eightfold Path in Buddhism. It is said that if you walk on this path, then surely you will get desired results. Surely you will be a wonderful leader or wonderful administrator. First path is right view. That means right perspective towards life or situation. नजरिया, जिसको हम नजरिया भी बोलते हैं, right? Clear? So if there is a situation in your life, however bad it may be, or however good it may be, or however confusing it may be, if your perspective towards that situation is good, then definitely you will find the solution, because every problem comes with its solution. हर problem एक solution के साथ आता है. Every problem comes with a solution. And if according to Chanakya, if a problem is coming to you, that means you are capable of solving it. Chanakya कहते हैं कि अगर आपके पास life में कोई problem आ रही है ना, मतलब life, universe जानता है कि आप में वो काबिलियत है उस problem को solve करने की. तभी वो problem आपको दी गई है, right? That is why that problem has been given to you, because you are capable of solving it, not anybody else. That is why every person has different problem, different set of problems, because only that person is capable of solving that problem. And the problem can be solved only if you have a right view. Second, right intention. If your intentions are bad, you will be a bad leader, or you will not be a leader, right? If your intentions are good, then the whole country, entire nation will follow you, which happened in the case of Mahatma Gandhiji also. Right speech. If you have a right speech, then only you can find solutions to a problem, and then only people will accept your solutions. People will follow your path only if you have a right speech. Right action. When right view is there, right intention is there, right speech is there in your life, then obviously your deeds will be correct. Right livelihood. The way you live your life, if it is correct, if it is in equanimity with the universe or with your neighborhood or with the society, then people will follow you. Right effort. Without effort, no work can be done or no task can be completed. If you have a right view, right intention, right action, etc., but you are not putting in efforts, then you may fail in that task. Right? Agar aapke paas perspective hai sahi padhai karne ka, intention hai ek civil servant banne ka, aap padhna chahte ho, books lekar aa gaye ho, resources aapke paas hai, sab kuch hai, sab knowledge hai, acche ho, but aap mehnat nahi kar rahe, aap lazy ho, to aapka exam clear nahi ho sakta. Right? So right effort, right mindfulness. As and when the distractions arise, become mindful and eradicate them. For example, you are sitting to study. Maan lo aap pad rahe ho. Right? And somebody enters your room and suggests you to go on a walk, or you know, go for a party, or go out for dinner or lunch, etc. Or your friend calls you. You are studying, but in the middle of your studies, your friend calls you and tries to talk to you, gossip with you for one long hour. Right? So if you have right mindfulness, you can avoid these distractions then and there by switching off your phone and locking your room for a specified period of hours to study. राइट अगर आपने टाइम टेबल बनाया है, टास्क इन हैंड लिया है और कोई डिस्ट्रैक्ट करने आता है, अगर आप माइंडफुल हो तो आप डिस्ट्रैक्शन को वहीं रोक सकते हो. राइट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. इफ यू आर नॉट फोकस्ड ऑन अ टास्क इन हैंड, देन दैट टास्क कैन नेवर बी कम्प्लीटेड, हाउएवर राइट यू आर. राइट, जितने भी आप अच्छे हो, जितने भी सच्चे हो, अगर आप में फोकस और कॉन्सेंट्रेशन की कमी है, तो आप कभी कोई काम नहीं कर पाओगे. राइट, द राइट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड टू कम्प्लीट अ टास्क. Now, what is the essence of Buddha's teachings? Buddha's teachings can be covered in four noble truths. What is this four noble truths? First truth which Buddha said is the truth of suffering. That means accept that there will be suffering in human life. Aisa ho hi nahi sakta ki koi kisi insaan ke life mein sirf achcha hi achcha hai. If there are ups, there are downs also. So accept it. If you are accepting the ups, then be generous and accept the downs also in your life. Secondly, when you accept the suffering, you will realize the cause of your suffering. जब आप suffering को accept कर लेते हो, आपको पता चलता है कि ये suffering आई क्यों life में. Third truth is truth that there is an end of suffering. That means if you know the cause, you will automatically know how to eradicate that cause. So there is an end of suffering. And fourth truth is path that leads to end of suffering. So if you know that the suffering can be ended, then there is a path by walking on which you can eradicate that suffering. For example, let's say an example. A student A, he could not clear his exam. Exam clear nahin kar paya. He was very hurt. First step he did, he accepted his suffering. He accepted that he was disheartened, that he failed the exam. Now second truth he will realize that there is a cause of this suffering. Cause is his own distractions, his own mobile phone. He is on various social media sites, for example, and those social media sites are distracting him. So he has now identified the cause of suffering. Third step, end of suffering. Now he knows that if my mobile is the cause of my suffering, it is the cause why I wasted majority of my hours in scrolling down the social media sites, exploring it, etc., etc. So now I know how to end the suffering. There is an end to this suffering also. And then he will devise the path to end the suffering by deactivating the social media apps, by deactivating Instagram or Facebook or Snapchat. Okay, so this is how he will end his suffering. So to end the suffering, you have to accept first that there is a suffering in your life. Do not resist it, accept it. Okay, so what are the ethical ideas of Buddhism? Let us understand. There are three essentials of life. There are three things which are very essential as per Buddhism in life. First is wisdom. Without wisdom, you cannot achieve anything. जब तक दिमाग आपके पास wisdom नहीं है ना, सही विचार, सही दिमाग, सही ख्याल नहीं है, तो आप कैसे कुछ अच्छा अचीव कर सकते हो? Wisdom means prajna. It comes from right view, चीजों को देखने का सही नजरिया, which leads to right intention. And right intention leads to right action, right? Second essential is ethical conduct, which is known as sila. Ethical conduct is a combination of right speech, right action, right livelihood and right effort. And then third essential of life is samadhi or concentration or focus, single pointed focus, which will come if you have right mindfulness and right concentration. Clear? Now always remember that Buddhist laws are not man-made laws. Man-made laws or social custom Buddhist ethics ka part nahi hai. Ye hamesha yaad rakhna. Okay, and Buddhism talks about focuses on actions. Actions will determine your work, your success. The good actions are known as kushala karma. Bad actions are known as akushala karma. And actions originate because of intention or motivation from which it originates. Right? Also, Buddhism talks about panchashila. That means five things from which you should refrain yourself. First is killing. Second is stealing, lying, sexual misconduct, intoxicants like drugs or alcohol or smoking. Okay, so these are the five things from which you have to refrain yourself in order to become a good leader. Now, how can you use Buddhism in your governance? That we will understand. But before that, we should understand the demeritorious deeds as per Buddhism. In Buddhism, there are total 10 deeds which are known as demeritorious. That means which are bad deeds. Okay, and these 10 deeds have been divided into 3 sets. First set is actions of body, that is killing the living beings, stealing, unlawful sexual intercourse. Second set is verbal actions, lying, slandering, harsh speech, meaningless blabbering or talking. Third set is action of mind, being desirous of something which belongs to others. किसी के पास गाड़ी है, उसकी आप रख रहे हो मन में इच्छा कि भाई यही गाड़ी, इसकी गाड़ी काश मुझे मिल जाए. किसी के पास नई वॉच है तो बोल रहे हो इसकी वॉच काश मुझे मिल जाए. तो किसी और की चीज पे नजर रखना, इच्छा किसी और की चीज के लिए बनाना, वो गलत है. इल विल एंड रॉन्ग व्यूज, दीज आर दी 10 मेरिटोरियस डीड्स विच आर हार्मफुल एंड विच कैन स्टॉप योर वे ऑफ प्रोग्रेस, योर पाथ ऑफ प्रोग्रेस. सो हाउ कैन यू यूज बुद्धिज्म इन गवर्नेंस? There is a doctrine of Das Vidya Raj Dharma which you can follow. This is the doctrine which is followed in governance. It has been taken from Buddhism. First point is tapa, that is self-restraint, controlling your senses, controlling your urges. Second is dana, that is charity, being prepared to sacrifice one's own life's pleasures for well-being of public, including serving the public interest. That is dana or charity. Third is ahimsa, that is non-violence. Fourth is morality, sila, moral responsibility of government towards its people. Fifth is khanti, that is forbearance, taking decisions with patience, with utmost patience. Seventh is najavan, that is gentleness. If you are humble, if you are polite, if you are not arrogant, then you can never defame others. You will always take wonderful decisions and people will always respect you and follow you. Eighth is ajivan, that is honesty, uprightness, performing one's duties with loyalty and utmost sincerity. It will increase your credibility. Ninth is avirodha, absence of obstruction. Tenth is parakaka, that is altruism, being generous and avoiding selfishness, practicing altruism, right? And this is the ever, you can say, green principle in Buddhism, that is akrodha, that is non-anger. And who are the most famous personalities who followed Buddhism in their governance? Governance mein Buddhism ko kisne follow kiya? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and Ashoka, King Ashoka, right? So this is how you need to study the ideas of Buddhism, the ethical ideas of Buddhism in your GS paper 4. I hope you enjoyed today's lecture. If you really enjoyed this lecture, do not forget to like the video, share the video as much as you can, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.